Tonight's shooting at Pearl Harbor comes just days before the 78th anniversary of the Japanese attack on that base.
And that attack prompted a young woman from the West Side to join the Army. And now her story is being told thanks to her grandson. Brad Underwood has this Local 12 exclusive.
Dear Diary, 1942. We're in the Army now.
Inside this little book, more than 3 years of wartime memories, thoughts, and life events, all handwritten by Lieutenant Arlene Reuter.
It was a lot of fun going through it. It was tough because I wanted to ask her questions and I couldn't.
Johnny Windhorst is Reuter's grandson. He remembers being a kid and hearing about her time in the war as a nurse.
As I became more interested in what she did in the war, she, the memories just kind of slipping away from her.
Reuter passed away in 2007. After her death, Windhorst found the diary. It took him some time, but he eventually transcribed it and made a book of those memories for his family.
It surprised my parents, along with my uncle, and my cousin and my sister, and they were just blown away.
Life, Love, and War is the book's title. Windhorst says the diary isn't really a World War II play-by-play of her time in Africa, France, and England, but more about his grandmother's personal time with a little war mixed in.
She kept it personal, you know, it's like she had some hard times in the war. Like she, I always heard about how my grandma almost married somebody else.
2 days in July of 1943, she writes of marriage one day and tragedy the very next.
She doesn't get into it because she's not telling the story. She's just writing down her thoughts. And as you read through, you're realizing he just died.
She also writes of times of treating the enemy at a hospital.
She would have to give them the same care. And they would, verbally, she said they were just really mean and, they would yell things at her while she's trying to help save them.
From life in tents to sing-alongs on trains with the troops, Reuter made the most of her time in the Army. And thanks to Windhorst's book, we have a different perspective of war told by a member of our greatest generation.
The fact that one copy was bought is just pretty awesome.
I think he's going to sell a couple more copies.
I've
gotten
so
a lot of
too.
Messages.
I'm into it already.
A lot of messages right tonight about it. That wasn't his intent to sell it. It was
sure.
Just to give it to the family to honor her memory. But by selling it, or at least offering it up to people, he said that's his way of keeping her memory alive.
That's so cool. I'm such a World War II fanatic. I mean, I love to read stories about that time in our history. And this one is especially neat because it's somebody from here.
Yeah. And he was, telling me, you're reading through it, he has to catch himself like, this is my grandmother?
Right.
But then darling, honey, would come in. He said,
right.
That's grandma.
That's
she used to call people that. So
cool.
Pretty
well
cool.
Done.
And a gift to his family.
Right.
Thanks, Brad.
Yeah.